Father Highland Park. Rachel Davis here, Director of Music at the Church at Highland Park, and welcome back to Hymn of the Week. Each Wednesday, we come together and talk about some of the good old classic hymns, their text, the music, their meaning, and the history behind them. This week, I'm so excited to share with you an all-time classic, How Great Thou Art, with text by Carl Boberg, set to a Swedish folk song. Let's check it out. But first, a small reminder. Each Wednesday, you can find me on Zoom at 7 p.m. as we work through our summer Bible study, Early American Stories, the study of book Go Tell It on the Mountain by She Reads Truth. Tonight, we're going to talk about the infamous hymn, Jesus Paid It All, its history, and share some of the stories that bring us closer to God through that hymn. If you can't find the Zoom link on the email that goes out with this video, please send me an email directly, and I'd be more than happy to share it with you. Hope to see you tonight at our weekly Bible study. But for now, let's jump back into the hymn, How Great Thou Art. The year is 1885, and we meet 26-year-old Swedish minister Carl Boberg, who finds the Spirit come upon him to write down this text into a poem. When I the world consider, which thou hast made by thine almighty word, and how the web of life thou wisdom guideth, and all creation feedeth at thy hand, then doth my soul burst forth in songs of praise, O great God, O great God. Carl Boberg publishes this poem, but he, as far as he knows, the poem becomes forgotten after published. It's not until several years later that Carl Boberg will hear his same poem set to the traditional Swedish folk song melody. Now we move from Boberg's Swedish homeland to Russia, where we meet English missionary Stuart Hine. Stuart Hine also experiences this singing of Carl Boberg's poem to the tune of the Swedish folk song, and he is so inspired by this performance that he decides to write his own arrangement, still set to the Swedish folk song. Stuart Hine writes his own three verses of this hymn, and this is where we get the traditional first three verses of this hymn. Here we have Dr. Hine finally taking the fourth verse back with him to Great Britain, where he has now created his own arrangement. Finally, we take our last trip across the world, where we land in Assam, India, where we meet Dr. Edwin Orr, who also hears local tribespeople singing Stuart Hine's text to the Swedish folk song melody. And Dr. Orr is going to take that singing arrangement of How Great Thou Art back to the Americas. And now that he's in North America doing a conference tour in California, we meet Tim Spencer, famous music publisher around the mid-1900s, who finally contacts Stuart Hine and copyrights the piece. Now the hymn is officially a hymn, and it's getting published in hymnals all around the country. Soon, to be all around the world. And that, my friends, is How Great Thou Art, with original text by Carl Boberg, soon to be Stuart Hine, set to that traditional Swedish folk song. I hope you've enjoyed our Hymn of the Weeks as we go through this time of virtual worship, and I love sharing these stories with you each and every Wednesday. Have a fun, happy and safe rest of your week, Highland Park, and I will see you next Wednesday.